Hello and welcome to the SGA Series here at Studio 73, where we feature individuals from an organization powered by the students who are working for the students. I'm your host, Delaney Fischetti, joined by Callie Morse. Thank you for being here today.
No problem. Hi.
So can you tell me what committee you are involved in?
I'm in the Public Relations Committee in SGA.
Nice. So what are some of your responsibilities in that committee?
We're responsible for making sure that the students know what's happening, like what SGA is participating in, what we're hosting, making sure that they know that they're welcome to be involved in all of those events. We do a lot of sharing on Facebook, retweeting on Twitter, all kinds of stuff like that, supporting everything.
So what is a typical meeting like for your committee?
A lot of brainstorming. Mm-hmm. We think about a lot of like did you knows. You know, we collect other information from senators for the who you should know, and you know, we just talk about when things should be shared and other events that are happening.
Are there any big events coming up for SGA?
Tomorrow, the SGA Awards. It's going to be very exciting. A lot of people are invited. Mm-hmm. It's going to be some good food. It's Gatsby themed.
Oh, that's so fun.
Yeah.
That's good for you guys. It's going to be an amazing event.
I'm excited.
So how do you feel that something that you have done through SGA has impacted the Suffolk community?
Most recently, last meeting, the SGA passed a resolution on diversity training for faculty, and I think that's something that's really important that should definitely be involved and integrated mm-hmm. on campus. I think it's a good way to make sure all students, you know, feel safe and secure, and you know, like Suffolk is their home, and I'm looking forward to seeing the results of that.
Yeah, me too. So what is one of your favorite aspects about being involved in SGA?
Definitely the friends that I've made, all the people that are in SGA, and then, you know, making friends with people who are outside and kind mm-hmm. of involved in SGA. I feel like I've definitely made a lot of solid friendships because we share, you know, the same understanding and the amount of care for the university.
Now, the big question, what does SGA mean to you?
Kind of feels like home.
Mm-hmm.
It's become so important to me. I really have enjoyed making sure other students understand like what it means to be at Suffolk and all mm-hmm. that it has to offer, and you know, making sure that they know that they have people who are here for them, and you know, making sure that people can feel that on and off campus and that it's always there.
Definitely, that's an amazing answer and good for you.
Thank you.
Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you.
So we will be right back with another SGA senator. Back with Denisha DeMornay. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. So what committee are you involved in?
I'm on the diversity committee.
Nice. So what are some of your responsibilities in that committee?
So on the diversity committee, we're in charge of pretty much raising awareness to all the different cultural, multicultural aspects of our campus. And some of the main things that we do will revolve around hosting a cultural fair, making sure that we're bringing awareness to different cultural activities on campus, and really just creating a safe space for our students within SGA and reflecting that outside the community as well.
Nice. So what are some of the things that you do during your meetings?
A lot of going back and forth about what, because it's kind of hard to just narrow it down to one diversity issue mm-hmm. that we're all really passionate about. So we kind of make a list of things going on around campus and talk about what we should do moving forward for certain things. If it's whether it's an event or if it's maybe something that we've noticed going wrong on campus, we kind of divvy out the work and talk about how we can best approach each situation, you know, and just pulling on each person's strengths on the committee. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of good people who are very, you know, from different diverse backgrounds, who are international students, who have that insight that mm-hmm. help us a lot with planning different things around campus.
Definitely. So how has something that you have personally done through SGA impacted the Suffolk University committee?
So this semester, I was able to write two different pieces of resolutions. One was the gender pronoun resolution, which basically asked that faculty and staff put their gender pronouns within email signatures to create mm-hmm. a more inclusive campus around gender nonconforming and transgender students who maybe use different pronouns than people mm-hmm. would assume them to use. So that's just a way that they can kind of create that inclusive environment as well as have the conversation in class. And then the last piece that I was able to get through was a diversity resolution, which passed through SGA last week. And that was just around diversity trainings and requiring faculty and staff to do so at least 1 to 2 times a semester so that they're aware of the different issues and different identities on campus so that they can feel more represented in our community.
Wow, good for you. That's amazing. So what is a goal of yours as a student leader here at Suffolk?
So I'm approaching graduation, and I guess, you know, just the pushing those two resolutions through was like my biggest focus this semester. Mm-hmm. But in overall, those kind of reflect my attitude about just bringing awareness to this campus. There are a lot of different identities on campus that kind of go unrecognized and not talked about or not talked about appropriately. Mm-hmm. So really just shifting the campus culture and understanding diversity, understanding what it means to be a part of a different identity group, and how we can make them feel included in our campus as well.
Well, I'm sure that you'll be missed after graduation.
Aw, thank you. I appreciate that.
So what does SGA mean to you?
SGA for me means that I have a voice. You know, I recognize that not every room or classroom is going to respond to a woman of color's voice in the way that I would like it to, but in SGA, I'm surrounded by so many welcoming and people who are just really interested in the well-being of our students, mm-hmm. Who really don't necessarily know everything about a certain topic around different identities, but are really willing to listen and learn. So I really feel safe in having a voice there, and I really appreciate that community for making me feel welcome.
That's amazing. Well, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
So that's it for the SGA series. We'll see you next time.